Hello everyone, and welcome to a new IBMi RPG sample video. Today I'd like to share with you an example of how data structures should be passed as parameters to a subprocedure in RPG. Let's go! Well, this seems to be a simple thing, but there are still many people who really doesn't know the correct way for doing it, especially with the new variable size structures. As always, we are going to do a simple example using VS Code and Code for IBMi. For anyone who has questions about how to use Code for IBMi to program with RPG, there are many videos on my channel about it that you can watch. Okay, let's start creating a new RPG source. Let me write this, the first lines. This is going to be a program without cycle. As you know, if I write here main, the first procedure will be main. Okay, but I can change it. I can, for example, write test 55, and then my main procedure should be test 95. Okay, it is completely the same. Well, as you know, to use data structures in parameters, you need to use templates. So let me create a template for my example. And this is gonna have, for example, three fields. Field number one, there's gonna be this type, field two, and field three, well, for example. Well, now imagine that I have a data structure with 1,000 records, okay? Then I will define it this way. Structure 1, for example. And this is going to be like DS, structure T. Structure T. 1,000. Okay, so structure one will have the same structure as structure T, but with 1,000 records. Also, I want it to be initialized as structure T, okay, with the values that I have here. For example, for field number two, I'm indicating here that I want it to be initialized, okay? Well, now I'm going to clear this structure, and now I'm going to create a subprocedure that will sum the field 2, this one, of every record of the structure. Okay, well, let me write it, for example, subproc 1. This is going to be the entry. I'm going to return a shown value of 10 positions, okay? Because I'm going to make a sum. Well, this is gonna be my parameter. I'm going to receive a structure of this type, okay? I'm using here again the template, and of 1,000 records, okay? And this is going to be a constant. Well, now we are going to go from 1 to 1,000. I'm going to sum field 2. Okay. Okay. And I'm going to return the sum. Okay, it's as simple as this. And in the main procedure, what I'm gonna do is to what I have to say is okay, well, I'm going to return this as a message, for example. Okay. So this way I will write to the job log the result of the sum calculated by subproc 1. Okay. Now imagine that I want to do the same, but I want to use an auto-dimensional data structure. Okay. So let me create it. I'm gonna copy this with a different name, structure 2. And in this case, I'm gonna do this. So this structure is different from this because this is an auto-dimensional structure, okay? Well, what will happen if I use the same subprocedure to make the same operation? In this case, the program will crash. Why? Well, because when I'm passing the structure 2 as parameter, all elements are empty, and then field 2 has wrong values, okay? Because it's not initialized. So, what's the better way for doing this? Well, for this kind of structures, it's always better to pass not only the structure, but also the number of elements it has. Okay, so let me write a different subprocedure. I'm gonna copy this. Gonna be subprocedure number 2, and I will need the number of elements. Okay, and now what I'm going to do is to change this to elements. Okay, and the rest of the code is completely the same. So what I can do in the main procedure is as you know, this way I'm initializing the structure, okay? And now I can do this too, and the number of elements that is this, okay? This way I will be able to pass my structure and the number of elements it has, and it will work correctly. Well, what if what I want to do is modify the structure that I pass as parameter? Well, this case is similar to the previous ones. The difference is that I cannot pass the parameter by value, but by reference. And we also have to use the bar size option in the case of variable size structures. If not, the compiler will give you an error. So, for example, if I want to fill the structure, I will do this. Okay, let me copy this subprocedure with a new name again. I'm going to have now subproc number 3. And what I have to change here is this. Okay, and I'm going to change also this, and I don't need this because I'm not going to return nothing. I'm going to change this. For example, two elements. Okay. And the way for calling to this subprocedure will be this. Okay. And okay, so I will call to the subprocedure this way, and after that it's important to set the number of elements of the structure, keeping the data inside, two elements. Okay, well, there is one more case. Imagine that I want the subprocedure to return me the structure. Okay, well, for that I will do this. Let me copy this subprocedure with another name, and now what I'm going to return here is the structure. Okay, and what I want to have here is the number of elements that I want the structure to have. Okay, so in this case I have to declare here a different structure, that in this case can be an auto dimensional structure. Okay, I will need another variable here, and what I'm going to do is, first of all, I have to initialize the structure. Okay, and now for 1, 2 elements, okay, for example, and I'm going to return this structure. Okay, let me remove it. Okay, and what I have to do in the main procedure is basically the same as I did with the structure number 3. Imagine that I have a structure number 3. I have structure number 4, like structure number 3. And here, what I can do is this: structure 4 is equal to subproc 4 elements. Okay, and after that, it is important to set again the actual number of elements of this structure that is going to have 1000. Okay, if I don't do this, I will not be able to access to the different records of my structure. Well, as you see, it will depend a lot on how you define your data structure, the way you define your procedures. It is very important to always know if what I'm going to do is modify the content of a structure or return a new structure. Additionally, it is also important to consider whether the structure has variable size or not. I hope the video has been useful to you. As always, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. See you in the next video, and thanks for watching.